Last class, we saw up to development of female gametophyte. In this session, we will see the topics of pollination, agents of pollination, outbreeding devices, pollen-pistil interaction, and double fertilization. The first topic is pollination. Pollination means transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma. These are two types. That is self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination are of two types. One is autogamy, another one is ketonogamy. Autogamy means transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the same flower. It takes place in bisexual flowers. Another one is ketonogamy. Here, transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma in different flowers of the same plant. For example, cucurbits. In this plant, male and female flowers are present in the same plant. Next one is genogamy. It is otherwise called as cross-pollination. That means pollination takes place between two different flowers of same species. In this, let's see agents of pollination. Pollination takes place by various agents. They are biotic and abiotic components. Mainly, abiotic agents are the wind and water. Wind pollinated flowers are having certain features. That is, flowers are very small, colorless, odorless and nectarless. Both the stigmas and anthers hang outside the perianth as tassels. Here, the pollen grains are small, light and dusty. Pollen grains are produced here is very large numbers. Stigma is hairy and feathery to catch windborne pollen grains. Next one is pollination takes place in flowers by water. Mainly water pollination takes place in aquatic plants. For example, water hyacinth and water lily. These flowers come out of the water surface and then flowers are pollinated by wind or insects. In submerged plants like Wallisneria, the female flowers reaches the surface of the water by long stalk and pollens released onto the surface of water. Here, pollen grains are covered by mucilaginous covering. Other than that, these pollen grains decay by water. Here we will see pollination take place by biotic agents. Some common biotic agents are bees, butterflies, beetles, wasps, ants, moths, birds and bats. Here bees are considered as dominant biotic agents. Let's see the features of insect pollinated flowers. These flowers are large, colorful, fragrant and rich in nectar. Flowers adapted to pollination by birds are brightly colored and secrete abundant nectar. Here floral parts are leathery. Generally these flowers are not fragrant. Plants like viola and oxalis produce two types of flowers. That is glistogamous flowers and zeismogamous flowers. In glistogamous flowers, never open at all. In this flower, male and female sex organs are close to each other. So, no other way, here self-pollination alone takes place. No chance of cross-pollination. In zeismogamous flowers, well-exposed anther and stigma is there. So, cross-pollination is possible here. Next heading is outbreeding devices. Here, continuous self-pollination leads to inbreeding depression. Naturally, flowers have some facilities that are outbreeding devices. First one is tychogamy. That means maturation of stamen and pistils of a flower at a different time so that self-pollination is prevented. Next one is self-sterility. In this, pollen grains are not able to grow over the stigma of the same flower due to the presence of similar sterile genes. Next one is unisexuality, nothing but unisexual flowers. Then next, Seismogramous plants has well exposed anther and stigma. So compulsorily cross pollination takes place here. Then next outbreeding device is protandry. That means the male parts mature before the female one. Next one is protogyny. That means in plants, female parts are mature before male parts. Pollen pistil interaction. We can't give guarantee whether pistil receives the right type of pollen. Pistil has the ability to recognize whether it is of the right type or wrong type of pollens. Suppose if it is right type, pistil accepts the pollen and promotes the pollination events that leads to fertilization. If the pollen is of the wrong type, the pistil rejects the pollen by preventing the pollen germination on stigma. The acceptance and the rejection of the pollens by pistil happening because of continuous dialogue between pollen grain and pistil. This dialogue is mediated by chemical components of the pollen interacting with those of the pistil. Pollen absorbs moisture content which is present on the stigma, then it starts germinate and develops pollen tube. This tube penetrates through the tissues of the stigma and style, and finally it reaches the ovary. Let's see artificial hybridization. This is used in crop improvement program. Here, desired pollen grains are used for pollination. This hybridization creates new genetic recombination with better qualities. This is done by emasculation and packing techniques. In emasculation, removal of anthers from flower bud before dehiscence using a pair of forceps. Emasculated flowers are covered by butter paper to prevent the stigma from unwanted pollen, that is called as packing. Then desirable pollens collected from other male parent and dusted on the stigma, and the flowers are repacked and fruits are allowed to develop. These techniques used only in bisexual flowers. Double fertilization. This event occurs after the pollen tube reaches the ovary. The pollen tube releases two male gametes. One of the male gamete fuses with the egg cell, which results in the formation of zygote. This zygote develops into an embryo. The second male gamete fuses with two polar nuclei to form a triploid primary endosperm nucleus. This develops into an endosperm. This is termed as triple fusion. Two fusion occur in an embryo sac, that is called as double fertilization.